Keep your distance, Echo. Eternal gratitude for your protection, Master. Old Bridget says you are one to trust. Keep your distance, Echo! Ascalon has stalked us for ages upon ages. Your place is not here. Seen beyond these walls in such a long time. Vampire hunters will never find us here.
Hello, Harriet. Do you recognize me?
Yes. You were from the Pembroke Hospital. The Yang Doctor. So full of secrets.
I have so many questions I need to ask you, Harriet. If you would.
I love questions. As for the answers, you may not like them.
I have a question of the utmost importance to ask. Will you answer?
Questions, questions, questions. The good doctor, always searching for answers.
Do you remember what you did after leaving the hospital? Did you kill anyone?
First, a question from me. You answer first.
Very well, then. What do you want to know?
Are you like me? Are you also dead?
We are not dead, Harriet. Death no longer pertains to us. We are different.
I like what I am. I truly do. I relish the pain that courses through me.
I know you fled the hospital with Sean Hampton. Did you or Sean kill anyone in your flight? Anyone? Try and remember.
I will not lie. I wanted blood, and I wanted revenge, and Sean pulled me from it, brought me here instead. But the shadows heard my prayers. The shadows killed that bastard.
Shadows? Tell me what you saw.
The shadows. They heard me and answered. Something in the deep darkness. Quick. Deadly. It asked me if I wanted revenge. I answered, yes.
And these shadows, this presence, do you still hear it? Was it a vampire? Did Sean see it?
It spoke only to me, and now it is silent, but it is born of hatred. And it will kill again. And it hates you, Doctor. Oh, it hates you.
What makes you say that?
It whispered your name, Dr. Reed. It wanted to know who you were and where you went.
Questions about me? What did you say?
Nothing, Doctor. I said nothing. There was nothing it didn't already know. Oh, I'm tired now. Let me rest. Let me rest now.
Have you found the answers you were looking for, young Ekon?
There is too much left unanswered. So many questions.
Get to know us. Spend time with us. And I may be willing to answer more questions.
What manner of creature is Harriet? She is different from everyone else.
I really don't know. I'm not even certain she is a Skull. I've no idea as to what blood made her.
What is a Skull, in fact, in your honest opinion?
The progeny of a vampire, disavowed by her maker. Perhaps a fruitless branch of a noble tree. A word used to enslave us. I cannot say.
You mentioned that vampire blood has tremendous potency. You believe it to be stronger than your own?
The vampire's sweet blood. That rich, dark wine that we crave. For it made us, and it can sustain us.
I thank you for your time, madam. I must go back to Sean Hampton now.
Your kindness has been ample payment, Ekon. To protect us, I'll close the access to our hideout, but you can use our shortcut to reach Mr. Hampton's shelter. Just follow the arrows.
For how long have you been in hiding here?
Skulls have been hiding under London since vampires first entered the city.
Where did you hide before the sewers?
We claimed ancient tunnels, forgotten caverns, catacombs. We are skulls, groveling beneath the feet of our makers.
Why do you live here, amongst the filth and vermin?
Live? Here we hide.
Why don't you leave the city? Hide somewhere far from the Guard of Priwen. The Ascalon Club.
We are the Sewer Skulls. This is our domain. We have run as far as we can, and now we hide.
What are you hiding from?
From the guilt, the shame, from the hunters and the light. And of course, our past.
Your diction, your words. You do not carry yourself like most Skulls I've encountered.
True. I'm not like most Skulls.
You were once someone else. What happened to you?
It is as sad as it is long, young Ekon, but it will remain mine.
Can I be of service to you?
We ask but one thing. Reveal to no one our secrets. Do not betray us.
Thank you, old Bridget. I hope we'll meet again.
How is London? I've not seen beyond these walls in such a long time. Old Bridget says you are one to trust.
It's locked.
Welcome back, Dr. Reed. Would you like to take communion with me now?
Sean, are you eating raw flesh?
It is the sacred flesh of the mortal lamb. Our Lord's bountiful transmutation for the sustenance of his believers. Thank you, Lord. I am your most humble servant.
So, true to your word, you waited for my return.
I told you, Dr. Reed, I was a man to be trusted. Did you have words with the poor Harriet?
This shelter is the tip of the iceberg. You hide your game well, I'll give you that.
We are God's children, Dr. Reed. One and all. And he's determined to save us.
Harriet, Miss Jones, has been behaving in a most violent manner. She's going to need special attention.
That's precisely the reason I brought her here. To meet old Bridget. She's the guide Harriet requires.
Harriet is possessed by her hatred. You cannot let her roam free. She's dangerous.
She has joined her own kind, Doctor. Old Bridget is a saint to the younger Skulls, guiding them to salvation and peaceful existence.
I believe I've learned all I need to know. I'm certain you've killed no one, but one day I believe you'll cross the line.
Logic is a false prophet. Faith is the only path to salvation.
What do you mean?
We have been blessed with God's eternity. We are the instruments of his divine will. We shall feed the hungry forever and ever. Amen.
Strive to emulate your merciful nature, Sean, but it's a difficult pledge to make.
Give yourself over to God, Doctor. Expel your urges and kneel before the Lord in praise.
These urges. You know the hunger will never be satisfied.
I've come to embrace the everlasting craving. I have sworn to feed only upon the flesh of the dead. It is now my sacrament. Take, eat. This is my body. So saith the Lord.
I really would like to believe your fairy tale. The good ghoul feeding upon the flesh of the dead. But I'm all out of innocence.
Do you question my faith, Dr. Reed?
Do you remember William? Oh, how his admiration for you was exceeded only by his hunger.
May his soul rest in peace.
A night will come, and you will suffer the same hunger. Someone who trusts you completely. A friend will die, never to wake.
You confuse your voracious appetite with my itchy hunger. I would never kill a friend, nor an innocent.
I believe you've discovered our defining difference.
No! No! Ah! I did!
another corpse thrown in the streets. Someone's playing a very sick game. I know this brooch. This is my mother's. A birthday gift from father. ...29 Pretty Orchard Street. That's near Poplar's district. Why would this man carry off my mother's brooch? I must go there. Good evening, Mr. Throgmorton.
Dr. Reed, can I be of any assistance? Have you noticed anything suspicious lately?
Did you see what happened to him?
Actually, yes. He was thrown from the roof like a vulgar log.
Who could have done that?
Who? Well, a vampire, of course. Look, bite marks on the neck and lacerations here. There is definitely a vampire close by.
Why is it that you sound so afraid?
You didn't see it. He was dead before he hit the ground. The strength required to do such a thing, well, it beggars belief.
Goodbye, and good hunting, Mr. Throgmorton.
You again? What do you want?
Did you see what just happened?
No, I didn't. And I don't care.
Really? Why is that?
Because this sexist pig is one of the four men who blacklisted me. Good riddance, if you ask me.
Well, I'll leave you for now. Goodbye, Miss Paxton.
Glad to see you again, Mr. Reed.
Did you see what happened?
No. I was coming back to the shelter from work when I heard an awful scream, and there was this man, dead, just in front of the building.
You saw nothing at all?
No, I told you, just that awful woman's scream.
A woman's scream? Are you sure?
Of course. It was terrifying. I thought it was my sister, so I ran. But it was a man I've never seen round here before.
Goodbye, Miss Paxton. I have this thirst for blood. Thank you.
Thank you. over there!
It's one of them!
Pretty Orchard Street. This is it. What's in there for me? There's been a fight here. This window was shattered with violent force. Someone's been pulled through it and dragged through the street. Who could have done that?
sense. Stay away, sir. Oi! You listening? It ain't you! He's dead!
This is the very flower my mother tossed on Mary's coffin. Someone is targeting my family. Only a golden watch in her pockets. The marks on this woman's neck were made by the fangs of a vampire. Her shoes and clothes are quite worn out.
I see you.
Right then. It's a sick game, but given no choice in the matter, I might as well win it. I won't let you escape. You're very fast, but I'll catch you. They've all been butchered. Still.
What have you done?
Vicar Larrabee, what happened?
Demon! Hell Scourge! Son of perdition!
Vicar! Jonathan is no demon. He's just a loving son, returned from the dead. Like your Christ, Vicar.
Mary, it has been you all along.
Oh, it's me, all right, precious brother.
Why did you lure me here?
I'm gathering the family. For a final reunion, all smiling, all dead. Thanks to the good Dr. Reed.
Mary.
Mother, say hello to your son.
Hello, Jonathan.
Mother, I...
What do we have here, Mother? The prodigal son has lost his tongue. Our Jonathan always had the first and last word at dinner. The entertainer, the star of our show.
Mary, let me explain.
Shut up. It's my turn to do the talking. I have this nasty hole in my chest, Johnny. It needs to breathe.
Right then. Speak.
My prayers went so long without an answer. My husband killed in France. My child carried away by the flu. My brother promising to return in his letters, then disappearing in thin air. I went from hospital to hospital, cemetery to cemetery, grave to grave. I've lifted every stone in London, searching for an end to the nightmare. And there you were, in front of me, on a dark pier.
It was the hunger. You know it now as well.
The joy to have finally found you. I longed for your arms, a final happy ending to so much tragedy, to tell me all would be well again. As you did when we were children. It was this filthy dock where you greeted your sister. I dug a tunnel from my grave with my fingers and teeth.
Mary, I had taken your life before I realized it was you. I tried to kill myself.
But you failed in your attempt. We cannot die, can we? We are a plague. I've watched you, Jonathan. You pull the strings and sever them.
I've done what I had to do. I did not choose this fate, but I will have my answers.
There are no answers, Doctor. There's nothing left but pain and lies and treachery.
Mary, wait!
Time to go, Mother. Give my regards to my son.
No!
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 This is what I do to those I cherish. Can you imagine what I have in mind for you?
I'll destroy you!
Finally, we hear the truth! Dr. Reed, admit it. You're a monster who takes joy in killing, who relishes the chase, the secrecy of it all.
I'm still a scientist. I shall find a cure for this madness.
You lie to yourself. Confess your sins.
Over the slaughtered corpse of our mother!
Are those tears, brother dear? Your heart still bleeds with emotion. My dead heart has dried.
You are mad.
Oh, so that's what I am, Doctor. Mad? I was beginning to wonder. I've been hearing voices, one in particular. That of my dead brother. This is the reason I must kill you. Not for your betrayal. Not for our poisonous kiss. Not even for the lies you tell yourself. No. So that smooth and wicked voice will stop ringing in my head!
I cannot let you kill again, Mary.
Time to die, brother. And this time for good! Sassy! Ah! Yeah! then kill him. Revel in your true nature. Kiss me again, sweet brother.
Nation.
Someone help me!
Abomination! Final thoughts are just to die for.
Ah!
Come to me, Jonathan. Sean Hampton.
This is despicable.
not in this grave! What have you done? Yes, Jonathan, kill him. Revel in your true nature. Jonathan. I'll show you the same kindness you show Sean Hampton.
Come to me, Jonathan.
Brother, it's time to bring this conversation to an end, forever.
You know I will not play this game.
Calm now, Doctor. Like a rabid dog. Or think you're performing an autopsy.
Don't be ridiculous.
I'll kill them all. The kind Dr. Swansea. The sweet little lass with hair of red. I am the Harbinger, bringing your punishment.
Mary.
Don't you see? This is not me. Flesh that never ages. All nightmare, no dream. Bring it to a close. Let me sleep.
I will find a cure, Mary.
At last, I can forgive you.
As I shed one last red tear for my fallen sister. I realize the entire world now revolves around this singular word. The epidemic that has stricken London is not the Spanish flu. It is transmitted through the blood via violent biting, turning survivors into frenzied immortals. I am Dr. Jonathan Reed. I am a vampire, born anew into an age of death and pestilence. While plotting factions close in around me, I am sworn to find the source of this epidemic. I am convinced greater perils are still to come. I know the answers I seek are hiding in our blood.
The flower's dying. It needs water.